So finally, we have Oculink support with mini PCs. This is the first, and it's from Minisforum. It is their UM780XTX. And with Oculink, it's the best method to connect up, say this, a RTX 4090 and get the maximum performance out of it without that overhead you normally get and the loss with Thunderbolt 3 or USB 4 eGPU setups. Oculink is 63 gigabits per second instead of the 40 you have with Thunderbolt, so that's why it's the best option. Now with this mini PC here, we've got an APU that is the Ryzen 7, that's the 7840HS. It's configured to 60 watts, the power limit, which is very high, and that does give a boost to the performance. Integrated graphics, which is the 780M, if you're not gonna connect up an eGPU, it's the best you can get for integrated graphics there is. And I've got, with this configuration, 32 gigabytes of storage and a 1 terabyte SSD, runs Windows 11. It does have Wi-Fi 6E, two USB 4.0 ports, and you can add two SSDs if you're not gonna go the route of an eGPU with the Oculink. And just to point out that Minisforum did send this out to me to review, but I'm not being paid for this video and all opinions in this, like always, are my own.
Okay, so let's take a look at what is included in the box. There's actually quite a bit. So there's this warning here to not remove the CPU cooler because they've used liquid metal. It's sealed in there and I'm not gonna touch it because I want the thermal results out of the factory. So that's why I'm not gonna go there with that. There's also this, a tip on the slow boot time. If it is slow, it's because of a BIOS reset, RAM replacement, SSD replacement. Then we have our user guide. Now this has a lot of information in here in various different languages. All about it, it goes over the ports, it shows you how to add the Oculink to M.2 card that's included and various other bits and pieces there. So well worth a look. There's this card on the top here, so you can put one of these in, and this is DIY, you can make your own one too, and that will shine through on the top lid just to, well, customization, just to make it look a little bit different. We have our power supply cable, that's gonna be either US, EU, and the power supply, great to see this, that it is a 120 watts, but this is a new one, a new style from them, that it's quite a bit smaller, a little more compact, always good. And then we have our base for the stand. There is the stand there. And then a VESA mount with the screws. And finally, this right here is our Oculink to M.2. So you have to give up one of those M.2 PCIe 4.0 slots if you're gonna be using an external GPU with Oculink. But at the time of this video, it's the fastest that you can get because it is, as I talked about in that intro, it's 63 gigabits per second instead of 40 via Thunderbolt. So it's the fastest there is. There's the Oculink port. You're gonna need to supply your own cable, the GPU mount and all the rest of that and the power supply for it. But it's fairly straightforward and great that they offer this option. Finally, the UM780XTX. Now you don't have to use the mount that is included, but for optimum cooling, it will be a little bit better, I believe, but you can just place it on the four rubber feet. So you can see there are the mounting points there for the VESA mount bracket. And at the front here, we have two USB type A's. Now these are USB 3.2 Gen 2 power on button. There is a microphone. This is the BIOS reset 3.5 millimeter. That does support microphones. And then we do have here, you can see USB 4. Now that's 40 gigabits per second. These two ports, while being Gen 2s, they are 10 gigabits per second. Then on the rear, you will see we've got a vent at the top. Here's our cooling fins. So that's where the hot air is gonna be coming out the back of it. Two 2.5 gigabit LAN ports. This is the power in. And then we have DisplayPort 1.4, HDMI 2.0, I believe it is. And then Oculink. Now the Oculink, of course, at the moment, I haven't installed it yet. There's a dust cap they include. So if you wanna use two SSDs, it only comes with one. So this configuration is 1 terabyte SSD, which of course has Windows 11 on it. And then we have the 32 gigabytes of RAM, two sticks. And if you wanted to add another SSD, you can do that, or the Oculink. Another Thunderbolt 4 port here, another two 3.2s, Gen 2s, and there is, well, enough ports, I think. So left and right, it's just vents. There is no, sadly, SD card reader. That would be nice, but they decided to put some huge vents either side, and I'll cover the thermals in this review, of course. So how do we access the internals and how do we install that Oculink M.2 adapter? So the lid here, no screws required to remove it, which is good if you're going to be customizing it a lot. So you just need to use your fingernail. It lifts up. There are some magnets right here that do hold it into place. You can see the two Wi-Fi antennas. Now be very careful with these. You do not want to damage them. Then you're gonna have problems with the Wi-Fi signal. So this is where you will slot in that card. If you wanna customize it, you can make your own later on. So this simply just slots in like so. There is a place here where it clips in. This is the 3M sticker there on the top. So what it's gonna do then is just, well, basically sit in like so, and then you are going to have that Tiger logo when it is on, or your own logo or whatever. Now, if you wanna go further, which you probably do, you wanna install maybe a second SSD or that Oculink adapter, you need to remove these screws on the outside, which is what I'm gonna do now. Just before I do, you can see here we have a heatsink and two thermal pads for the SSDs. Good to see that Minisforum have done this. And there is this fan here that is keeping these components cool. Mainly the SSD, but this is gonna help blow a little bit of air around where that RAM is too. And then it's just like installing an SSD. So you need to slot that in the upright position here. So this is PCIe 4.0, but only at times 4 speed with Oculink. However, that's just so much faster than using Thunderbolt. So we have that screw that I need to then screw that into place. So that is going in now. And we are done. That is our Oculink adapter installed. This is our BIOS, and if you go into setup, there are a few little options that are interesting you may want to change, and you don't have to go in here, and I don't recommend going in this if you're not happy with tweaking and maybe getting it to brick, but you can reset the BIOS. So under power configuration, if you do click on this, you'll find it's in balance mode by default. You can put it into performance. Now in balance mode, I do see it pulling up to 65 watts, so I'm going to leave it as is. I'm going to review it out of the box. And another interesting setting is if you go into AMD CBS. Now, if you find this one, which is MBIO Common Options, you find here you have the graphics configuration. This is for the integrated graphics. You've got UMA specified, and you can specify exactly how much RAM you want dedicated to it. Now, this will help boost up the frames per second a little bit, but I'm going to review it with just the 2 gigabytes. So you can set this all the way up to 16 gigabytes. It's great to see that Minisforum are now giving us that option. And there's various other things in here you can tweak, but I really don't recommend it. That's all you really need to know there. And you can set it to resume power on state if you're going to be using this as a server. And let's just get out of this now and head into Windows. Now the version of Windows it is running is Windows 11 Home. It's not Pro. Now I've updated the drivers, the AMD Adrenaline drivers and all of that before I started all my benchmarks, my tests and everything. Does it feel fast, this mini PC? Yes. Everything loads in really quick and snappy. Video playback absolutely flawless as I would expect for the 780M. So I'm on the integrated graphics at the moment and it does not drop any frames. It plays back every single file I tend to throw at it, so that is great. We've got the 32 gigabytes of RAM. It's running at its correct speeds in dual channel. That is checking out there. Now in the device manager, you'll see that, okay, we're gonna have the CPU there listed 16 times because it's got the 16 threads, the 8 cores, and you'll see this is our wireless card. Now it's a killer. This is the Wi-Fi 6E. And it's a very good card, so great to see that is on board really fast. And our drive, Kingston, you can see the model number right there, 1 terabyte. Not exactly what I would call fast for PCIe 4.0. Now it's just over that of a PCIe 3.0, but it's good to see they're using brand components here, so that is good. Checks out. So onto the benchmarks, I won't get too carried away with this because I know it could be quite boring, but they have to be shown here so you can compare this to other mini PCs I've reviewed. So you can see Geekbench 6, really good scores. I mean, look at that multi-core score, over 12,000 points there. And the integrated graphics, so the Radeon 780M getting close to 3,000 points. That's a very good score. The 65 watts that they have for the power limit definitely is helping out there. So that's good for the benchmarks. I'll get onto the eGPU stuff soon, but I want to finish on just the thermals here. So you can see that the chipset is getting up to our APU 75, almost 75 degrees, and that is really good, pulling the 65 watts. It's a lot of wattage, so the cooling's checking out. And yes, I can confirm, no random reboots, no suddenly powering off. It does seem to be stable on the current BIOS version that I'm running. And here is a sample now. What are you going to expect from the fan under full load? This is a Cinebench run, what you hear now. It's pretty good. I like the fan noise on this. It's not offensive. They're still on the integrated GPU. I'm having a look at some video editing here, 4K, one of my reviews. And the timeline is quick, as you can see. Playback, I'm not noticing any slowdown there or any drop frames, but I do have it set to a quarter playback resolution, so that is helping. So these basic edits here that I have, the timeline is, well, this video is up to 12 minutes and 42 seconds. Everything seems to check out. It's fine. I'll check on the export times now. So this is going to be with the YouTube 4K preset. Now, it wasn't exactly a quick export without Intel's QuickSync. It took 10 minutes and 58 seconds to fully encode this 12 minute and 42 second 4K clip with Adobe Premiere Pro. But what happens now when I connect up an RTX 4090? What kind of difference will an external GPU make? The difference is huge. You can see it finished up in just 4 minutes, exactly the same preset and the same APU, the same video, of course. And most of the work was done by the RTX 4090 and yes, the Ryzen 7 too. Okay, so onto the eGPU testing. Now, this is my Oculink dock that I am using, okay? It's very basic, and it's actually quite a cheap one that I got off Amazon. This was around about, I think off the top of my head, around about 25 US or something like that. This is the Oculink cable. Now, it does have a little connector that locks into place. You need to press down, so it doesn't just pop off by mistake. Now, yes, you can, of course, just run on any other mini PC or laptop an eGPU setup like this with Oculink, but you, of course, have to lose one of those M.2 slots, which we're doing here. Now, this does mean that it's just a bit tidier, I find, this kind of setup. Instead of having maybe a hole in a laptop or a mini PC and the cable sticking out, that is what the connector looks like. It looks almost like a display port, but of course it isn't. It's very different there. And that is the power supply that you're going to need one of those. Now, this is an old Thunderbolt rig that I have set up, eGPU dock, sorry, okay? So I'm just using the power supply sitting in that just to keep things a little tidy, even though it does look very messy. And this is the RTX 4090, an absolute mammoth of a card, power hungry, yes I know, but hey, I wanna set some world records here for an eGPU setup. Okay, so I finished running Timespy and now that's an insane score, and yeah, that's a new best. I managed to get a world record here with this combination of having the Ryzen 7 7840HS plus the RTX 4090. Now, the graphics score there in my desktop with a 13900K overclocked, I can get about 36,000 for the graphics score. So what's holding it back is our CPU, just a little bit there. Now this is gaming with our integrated graphics. Starfield default settings with the low preset 720p. And look at this frame rate. That is very good. Although the game looks at 720p, yeah, not amazing. It looks a little rough because it is using the upscaling. It's using FSR and all that sort of stuff. The dynamic resolution and whatnot. But the good thing is that frame rate is looking very good. So that's 720p. I'm going to up the resolution now to 1080p, still with the integrated graphics. This is holding up really well. That Radeon 780M, fantastic performance, pulling 60 watts, and it's throttling just a tiny little bit. It should be the whole time holding 2700 megahertz on its core clock, but you know, that's not bad at all, considering. And the thermals, I'll check those out before. It's not going over 75 degrees normally, so very good. The thermals, fan noise is checking out, and this is just so playable for integrated graphics. Sure, around this area, this is Neon. It's very busy. There's a lot of NPCs, a lot to render here, but that's good. That's really good. For integrated graphics, absolutely amazing. Hello. Getting around about 60 frames per second here. So well done with this performance, AMD and Minisforum. Now with the RTX 4090 Oculink, you can see I've got the resolution and everything cranked right up. So I have it set onto high and this is now 4K. So just quickly show you there. So the high preset, and it doesn't seem to be bottlenecking it at all, the APU. You can see the frame rate is, it's a very demanding game, especially with the settings that I have. So getting around 100 frames per second at 4K, that is really good. And it's pulling around about 300 watts. So even though it's only PCIe 4.0 at just times 4, at 4K, you're not really noticing that at all. The Witcher 3, now I do have this set to low settings. I turned off FSR, that's completely off here. And look at this frame rate, for 1080p, I am surprised. In fact, I was so surprised, I went into the settings like I'm doing right now, went to video, just to double check the resolution because I was thinking, oh hang on, am I running 720p? No, definitely 1080p, borderless window. And this performance, just amazing. This is the best I have seen yet. The Witcher 3 on the latest patch, running this area of the map, which is normally very laggy and demanding for integrated graphics, but wow, this is good. Amazing here. I'm impressed. The Witcher 3 using the same save spot again, and look at the difference. I, of course, have the resolution set to 4K, and I decided to set it to the ray tracing, the maxed out settings here. And I'm only getting around 74 frames per second, but visually, wow, it's absolutely stunning. Look at that, looks great. And the GPU is still pulling about, well, sometimes close to 300 watts here. So yeah, power hungry GPU, of course. A good performance, and no, it's not really bottlenecking it at all, the mini PC, as much as I thought it might. And finally, just a gaming benchmark here. This is Shadow of the Tomb Raider. 4K, the highest possible settings, quality for our DLSS, and it pulled out an astounding 189 frames per second. That's really good. Now, the best I have seen ever with Oculink is a 13980HX with the same exact GPU, which managed to get 226. But considering the APU it's using, this is an impressive result. And the Linux fans, well, you are going to be happy. Here I did boot up Linux Manjaro open source drivers, and it is running just fine. The wireless is working, everything does seem to work, so that is good. And the performance, as you would expect, is very, very good with this configuration running this APU.
So checks out with the fan noise, the thermals, the option we have on this to add that eGPU is fantastic. So you can remove that bottleneck you get with Thunderbolt enclosures, external graphics. So if you're using USB 4, Thunderbolt 3, Thunderbolt 4, you're never going to get anywhere near the performance you can with Oculink. It's the best option right now at the 63 gigabits per second versus the 40 gigabits per second we do get with Thunderbolt 3 or USB 4.0. So it's a good thing to have on a mini PC. A lot of people will say, well, that's a waste of an M.2 slot. Well, then don't install the adapter. You know, you can install a second SSD. You can even set up RAID if you wanted to. Minisforum configured this with 60 watts LTDP. Really good to see. So they're squeezing even more performance out of this APU. And I'm really impressed with the gaming performance at 1080p, The Witcher, Starfield, the kind of frame rates I were getting for integrated graphics. Absolutely fantastic there. So thank you so much for watching this review. Hope to see you in the next one. Do subscribe for more.